And so they, like, took this thing that never in the story was a negative thing. Like, Goody Two-Shoes, the character in the story, was never, like, too good or was never portrayed as, like, annoying. But somehow it got taken from, like, that character in the story to being this other thing in the way that language doesn't make any sense. I love that.
I love that, too. English in particular makes no sense.
No, yeah, we're not trying to make sense.
Like, in German, when they want to talk about the kinds of food that you eat when you're sad, they have a word for that, and the word is grief bacon. Like, German words make perfect sense.
Yeah, and we're like, goody two-shoes. You know, good people with two shoes. It's
who are bad.
This next question comes from Diana, who asks, Dear Hank and John, why do microwaves rotate the food when I use them? Remember that you are going to die, Anna.
Thanks, Anna.
No, it's Diana.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
It's like a memento mori stuffed inside of your own name.
Yeah, name specific sign off and Dear Hank and John specific joke. There are areas in the microwave that receive more energy, and that is a quirk of the physics of microwaves. And so you want your food to rotate in and out of those areas, or only one area of the food will get hot. It would be better if the food both rotated and actually moved, but that would be more expensive and difficult to have a mechanism that did that, and that mechanism would be more likely to break.
That's a very easy answer. I have a follow-up question, which is, Why don't I ever remember when reheating soup to put something on top of the soup so it doesn't explode everywhere?
You just gotta be like my friend who has this greasy, terrible piece of wax paper that they use and keep it next to the microwave and use the same one every time.
No. I don't like that at all. I would rather clean out my microwave after every reheating. Hank, you're really doing a great job with the physics questions, with the sand and the microwave. I have a physics question for you.
Okay.
Why did my bathroom glass wall blow up last night?
I really don't know. Was there a significant temperature change?
There was. And one thing we read on the internet is that sometimes when there are significant temperature changes, the glass doors in your house blow up. So, I wish somebody had given me a quick heads up on that one, maybe before we had it installed. All right, Hank, we have another question. This one's from Leah, who writes, Dear John and Hank, if a friend asks me to hang out, but I don't care what activity we do, is the proper response, I'm down for whatever, or I'm up for whatever? Directionally confused, Malia.
So here's the situation. In the great words of Brass Construction, John, Hey, well, leave your troubles behind. This is what we say to you. Get up, get on down, gotta get up, gotta get up, gotta get up, get on down, gotta get up to get down.
So you have to be up for whatever in order to be down for whatever.
Apparently, according to Brass Construction, you cannot be down unless you have gotten up for whatever.
I feel like it's I'm up for whatever. Indeed. I actually agree with Brass Construction insofar as I think the initial response is I'm up for whatever. But then if somebody replies with three options, maybe at that point you say I'm down for whatever. I also feel like, to be completely frank with
you, why is that right? I don't understand. That seems very right.
I also think, to be completely frank with you, there's something just slightly romantic about I'm down for whatever, whereas I'm up for whatever is completely platonic.
I'm so glad that we have made it this hard to speak this language.
This is a terrible language, and it's just occurring to me. And I know we have beer and whatever. Like, it's the spelling, it's ludicrous. Even ludicrous is ludicrous to spell. Like, that is essentially what the success of the hip-hop star Ludacris's name is based on.
Right.
That, like, ludicrous as a word is spelled incorrectly.
He can do it better. I can do this better, he thought to himself.
And he, by the way, he can. Like, the way that he spells ludicrous Pictures is much better.
He was correct, yeah. But, so, let me posit that I am up for whatever. It's just sort of, it's like saying, I am happy to do an activity, whereas I am down for whatever means I will do anything.
Right. I am up for whatever is like, I don't care if we go bowling or if we, like, throw axes. I'm down for whatever is like, if this
it's
ends
like
in a criminal enterprise, that's fine by me.
Yeah, it's like the chaotic good of I would like to hang out.
Which reminds me that today's podcast is brought to you by Ludacris. That's right, Hank. I'm going back a little bit. Just be clear, the artist, not.
This podcast is also brought to you by the glass door industry installing very small.